bricklayers is happening. It is already on Kiri Moto, it will be on Orca Slicer this year, but you can use bricklayers today, right now. I am so excited for you to use it, because making it work was... I need to sleep and shave. But really, this script only exists because of your support, so thank you. It is working on Orca Slicer, Prusa Slicer and BambuStudio, both with the Classic Engine and Arachne, but we need to talk about Arachne in a moment. It works with a full plate of objects. You can set at which layer it starts bricking, so your first layers will stick fine. And my favorite feature, you can easily see which walls are moved up, because I am generating a separate layer for them. I borrowed Stuart's idea from Kiri Moto, and I love to see what stays in the normal height and what goes half layer up. It is bricking around holes quite well, the models can have overhang walls and nothing breaks. Arc support is basically
killing me, Arc is...
And I am this close to make cancel objects work on Bambu printers. By the way, do you really use cancel objects in your printer? Tell me in the comments. Yeah, it is a Python script. If you watched TenTech's videos, you know the idea. But this one is not so experimental. Since the beginning, I was testing on real models, and I need to say the bench was... Yeah, the bench teaches a lot. But that's the idea, right? We need challenging stuff to test. And eventually, you learn how to do it. To make a bunch of automated tests, I also made command line options to write on a separate file or another folder and use a postfix. I could repeat the tests on dozens of models, see the changes side by side. I could see how much memory it was using, how fast it was. And it was not fast in the beginning. A benchy would take more than 15 seconds. Now it is doing in 4.
Whoa!
But get this, I also made it run with PyPy instead of normal Python, and it dropped to less than 1 second. This is insanely fast. Now, bricklayers is for functional parts. Please don't try multicolor printing. Multi-material is not supported yet, and I have no idea if that's realistic unless we are doing it in the slicer itself. So, let's talk about why my script is really big. The slicer knows a lot of things, but once it spits out a G-code file, a lot of that is lost. Information we need to make bricklayers work. The big missing piece, the depth of each wall. To shift every other loop upwards, I first need to know which loop is which. If you look at a cube, it is very easy. You just number the outer wall as 0 and count upwards as you move inside. But at the hole, now you need to do the same for the inner walls around the hole. And when you get a very complex shape, there are many jumps. The slicer knows this hierarchy perfectly, but none of it makes it into the G-code. So my script has to rebuild this entire map. Our brains can visualize these patterns very easy when we look at them, but the script, it needs math to figure out which loop is inside which and how deep each one is. That's why I used bounding boxes. They are fast to calculate, and they are beautiful to watch. This map of nested loops needs to be calculated on every layer. With bounding boxes, I can rebuild the correct loop order, even when the model shrinks, grows, or twists into weird shapes. And here we need to talk about Arachne. On Prusa Slicer, you can choose Arachne or Classic. It doesn't matter, because the walls are always wrapped together. But on Orca, sometimes it separates the loops. Here, this last line started orphaned, separated from the other loops. And it just continues elsewhere, as if they were part of the same structure. For normal printing, it doesn't matter, but it creates glitches on my brick sequence. So, Classic Engine works perfect on all three slicers. Arachne is perfect on Prusa, but not completely predictable on Orca and Bambu. It would be so much easier if Verbose Gcode exported real information about the lines. For bricklayers, I just needed depth. The slicer has this number on every loop. Imagine how much more powerful post-processing scripts would become. So, how well it prints? I have good news and bad news. Stefan from CNC Kitchen started this discussion because of strength. Igor from MyTechFun also measured it. Bricklayers was about strength. But I just noticed another advantage. Dimensional accuracy. If you already used the inner-outer-inner option, it is even better than that. Because on bricklayers, the walls are printed separately. They don't push each other sideways in sequence. They are fused centered, where they should be. Then the nozzle goes up and starts melting down the other half of the walls. Even if you increase the flow, it tends to overflow up, not so much to the sides. In my tests, I found that the best multiplier is between 1.05 and 1.1 tops. The bad news is, if the model has a lot of travel, I am still getting some stringing. That's because we are changing the order of the loops. I even made my own wiping routines with retractions and jumps. It's much better now, but not perfect yet. And the travel paths are not smart. I don't have the same intelligence that Orca has. It can be figured out, sure, but it almost feels like I am recreating a slicer outside of the slicer. Why I made this script. On FormNext, I talked about bricklayers with Prusa, with Litchi. The patents are a concern. By the way, I'm still editing the long conversation I had with the attorney professor Christa Laser about the patents in December. I also talked with Stuart, the creator of the Kiri Moto slicer, and surprise, surprise, he was the first one to implement bricklayers on a slicer. He is such a brilliant guy, he did it in less than 24 hours. You just need to activate it in developer mode. But this script is far from perfect. But that's the point. This is a playground for everybody to test bricklayers and discover where it is good and when it's not good. And if we know what we want, then we can shape how we want it implemented in the slicers. This took so much time and effort, the script and the video. I hope it's useful for you. Once more, your support, buying a thanks, or supporting me on Patreon, it makes all the difference in the world, and I really appreciate. Try the script on GitHub, you can post the problems you find, and I'll try my best to make it better. Thank you so much. And I'll see you here on Geek Detour.